Sorry, yeah.
This is Jasmine, Juhi's brother's wife.
Okay.
Arya's wife.
Okay. Haan ji. Okay.
Postman, please. Already written before I took his hair.
Ma'am, ek solo.
आराम से करेंगे भाई, आराम से करेंगे। सर रुकिए सर। राजी राजी रुकिए।
राजी यहाँ पे।
अरे
मरे जा रहे थे भाई।
कंट्रोवर्सी पूछेगा किसान ना।
थैंक यू सर। बाय गांधी।
सेंटर में सर, सेंटर सेंटर है।
हाँ सांग सांग सर, मेरे नाइन सर
सेंटर सेंटर है
सर। अभी थैंक यू।
जॉन जॉन
जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन
जॉन जॉन जॉन
जॉन जॉन
जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन
जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन जॉन
सर 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 राइट राइट
राइट
जॉन सर जॉन सर यहाँ पे
जॉन सर राइट में राइट
सर
अरे खाली बसा
मोबाइल।
अरे नीचे बैठो, नीचे मोबाइल। अरे खाली बस। अरे
अरे सोहेल भाई,
सोहेल भाई।
अरे यार
साइलेंट मोड, थैंक यू वेरी मच। पीपल राइट एट द बैक, यू कैन कम इन फ्रंट, देयर आर लॉट्स ऑफ सीट्स आई गेस। So let's start without any more delay. A very warm welcome to all of you. My name is Sudha and I'm the editor of this book. It's such a great privilege to be here in this town. And before we start anything, as it is our culture, let's first acknowledge certain senior members of the Mr. Raj Gobar. Thank you so much for gracing it. Nadira ji, thank you so much. Deepti ji, thank you.
For several books, he's the one who actually penned these stories, of course, after conferring with who else? Arunso. And here he is, a very familiar face. So these two, when I was editing the stories, I thought it would be a nightmare because there is a writer and there is a very busy actor. But I have to say that I do a lot of books by politicians and everybody. They don't give me the time, the kind of time that these two people gave. He would write something, we would confirm, we would say it doesn't work, let's do it again, we'll go back. And but by the way, I have seen all the repeats of Crime Control, and my husband only sees that, and you know, it's like my song in my life. So therefore, I knew most of the story. I saw that and watched it. So I watched all the shows, so it was very, very easy. Thank you so much, Oswald and Anu. He has something for all of you. I'm not going to really be in the suspense. Anup Soni, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much. Thank you, Raj sir. I just want to mention, Raj sir has just come to Bombay from Delhi. Aaj Delhi mein bahut fog tha, bahut saari flights delay hui hain. Lekin ye sirf is function ke liye aaye hain. He landed at around 3:15 and he's taking a 7:30 flight back to Delhi. So thank you so much for that. Thank you so much, John, for being here. Means a lot, your support, your love for this book and for me. Thank you for that. Thank you, Nadira ji. Thank you, Deepthi, and thank you, all of you. So, we just start with this, a small 40-second poetry, which is written by our friend, Darshan. It basically talks about ke book kya, how's crime is becoming part of our life and we are becoming so used to it that ke fark nahi padta. So, jab tak wo hamare cross mein ho raha hai tab tak theek hai, lekin jab tak hamare ghar par nahi aa jata tab tak hame fark nahi. So, we have to come out of that. We have to feel that it's our responsibility to be aware, not only for us but for others too. So I invite Darshan, who has written this poetry. Darshan, please.
तिवारी जी कर गया वो लिंकिंग रोड वाली रेजिडेंशियल बिल्डिंग गिर गई. ट्रैफिक होगा ना वहां पे, खून के छींटे. शर्ट खराब कर दिया यार. वो नुक्कड़ वाले बैंक में डकैती हुई है. वो एटीएम बंद होगा तो उगली छोड़ के दूसरी वो यूज कर देंगे.
कल रात को लैंडलॉर्ड का मर्डर हो गया.
इस महीने का रेंट शायद माफ होगा ना.
राजधानी हुई शर्मसार. नाबालिग का बलात्कार.
लगता है फिर से कोई लड़की दिन ढलने के बाद घर से बाहर थी.
मध्य प्रदेश में लड़की होने पर नवजात शिशु की हत्या.
इंस्टेंट जस्टिस है.
क्यों इतना अजीब क्यों लग रहा है? अगर इसी गति से जुर्म हमारे समाज में समाएगा तो वो दिन दूर नहीं जब ये भी आम हो जाएगा. ये सब होता है हर पल. अगर मैं आज हूं तो ये कल है.
इतना जुर्म कहानियों का हिस्सा हुआ करता था, आज जिंदगी का हिस्सा हो गया है. सुनकर अनसुना कर दिया, देखकर अनदेखा कर दिया. ढीठ हो गए हम पत्थर के भांति. औरों के दुख दर्द बस अब कहानियां हमारे लिए. खोखली हो गई हमारी छाती.
दौड़ भाग में इतने गुम हो गए कि लोगों की जिंदगियों के दाम नहीं रहा. पहले दीवारें भी इन्हें सुन लिया करती थी, अब तो दीवारों के भी कान नहीं.
न्याय के नाम पर मुआवजा लेकर लोगों का काम नहीं हो जाता. अगर जुर्म बार 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 होता है वो फिर भी गलत होता है, वो आम नहीं हो जाता.
शोर की आड़ में आवाज दब जाती है, चुप्पी की आड़ में चीखे दब जाती है. जुर्म को इतना नजरअंदाज ना करो कि नाक के नीचे हो और अंदाजा भी ना हो.
देखते सब है लेकिन किसे याद नहीं रहते. हम सुनते सब है लेकिन कहीं कुछ नहीं कहते.
परसों विदेश में हुआ जो
कल नगर में होगा,
आज पड़ोस में हुआ जो कल घर में होगा. थैंक यू.
So far as you are concerned, thank God that you are not unidimensional. So you are an actor. He is somebody who is majorly into sports. He is somebody who is not really, you know, below the arc lights. He does a lot more. He steps out there and does a lot of things. He is health conscious. He is basically somebody. We are so grateful that you are here this evening. Thank you so much. Please come and join us. Thank you so much. जब तक वो हमारे आस पास ना हो, हमारे साथ ना हो, तभी अच्छा बहुत बुरा हो. बट आई थिंक दिस इज अ बुक विच एक्चुअली डज वन थिंग टू ऑल ऑफ अस एंड दैट इज दैट क्राइम कैन लुक सो ऑर्डिनरी. आई मीन इट डजंट कम विद दिस मेजर साइंस दैट यू नो. सो देयर इज समबडी लर्निंग अराउंड यू. or you are getting signs from your relative, from your friend, from your spouse, that he or she is actually conspiring something against you. It all looks very nice, it's rosy. It's like a day, you know, an ordinary day in the life of somebody. And these are the stories which actually then tell you that you have to get the signs, and you have to get the signs and recognize those signs when the time is right. You have to be more alert towards these signs than anything else, which all of us are. Murders within the family, there is lust, of course, there is love, there is one husband conspiring against wife. Lots of, there is a variety of love crime you can tiptoe towards your life in various outcomes. So I'm going to today keep this, around crime and how we can unravel it and understand. So let me start with you. You know, there is a story right at the end, which is called Shiru Forever. So when I was editing that story, I couldn't. So I gave up. I just couldn't bring myself because, you know, one would get emotional because it was written in such a fashion that you can actually visualize what the person was going through. I want to ask Oswald that of all the stories, which one was it which was tough for you to get out?
Well, by mobile, are you?
I am all stories of her.
Yeah.
So I don't want to have favorites, but yes, the Shiro Forever ever was a tough story to write because it's about her acid victim. And here she fights her oppressors. And her oppressors commit the crime and they're left out on bail. After serving just 3 months and they are imprisoned for 9 years. But the judge, you can understand the state of her emotion. They are still out on bail. And I spoke to the victim, the asset victim. She sounds so, still sounds so positive. She says the future ahead of her is very bright. And she's not negative at all. And her oppressors are married. They have children. They're leading a good life. And she's totally blind. She's disfigured. She talks through a laptop.
Yeah, so this is a real story, like you said, and the perpetrators are out and she went from one place to another. The entire family went bankrupt and there was little they could do. But if they had done something about those bunch of boys who used to hang around near her house and tease her every day, aate jaate. I'm not saying that, you know, and I'm not a soothsayer and I'm not clairvoyant, but maybe. So it is just about how you go about like a film of yours, where your entries, that you're filching a camp, you're filching a phone.
We'll
go through that, and I want to ask you that there is crime around us, no one likes crime. But do you think vigilance is very important? What do you think, even petty crimes to serious crimes? Police force, which does a wonderful job, by the way, cannot be, you know, the onus is not on them. What do you think is upon all of us as families, as a community, to see that we are vigilant?
So, first of all, I'd like to. Thank you for having me. I'd just like to, Sudha, thank you for really presenting this book. Also, great job. Thank you. And Dipti ji, Ariya ji, Ji, such an honor sitting here. It's quite embarrassing sitting here when you're there, first of all. Very important, coming to the point, I think what Darshan and Anup just read out is exactly what happened. So, when you're asking me what I think about crime, we have to be sensitized to it, but we are not. So what happens is, when we are sitting here on these chairs, you know, we are sitting here, we are talking about it, right? The minute you step out, you forget about it. Because it's not happening to you. So I think it requires a lot of commitment to be sensitized to crime, even petty crime. Robbery in the house, a murder somewhere. Because someone's life is lost, someone's money is lost, someone's hard-earned money. So I think it's a... it's a conscientious process which we as human beings have still not gone into, because by human nature, we're generally very selfish by human nature. So till it doesn't happen to you, you're not really going to bother. So I'm not saying that as a negative, but that's how we have made it, that's how we constructed. So that's why there are exceptions in society. When they do so much more, they stand out. So I think we really need to do that, which is why, you know, when you make certain films like on a vigilante, he suddenly stands out because you made a film on a vigilante, because he's doing something that's exceptional, that's out of the society. And I think that's important to really, for each one of us at a micro level, to stand up, Sudha.
Thank you, that's such a lovely desensitized and we're going to forget it. And Anu, you did this show, but of course the book is more important now. The process of osmosis, as I'm seeing on stage. So when you would do the show and the book, you were going through it. Throughout the process, was there a time when you said that, you know, I do this almost every day, in any story, that there came a point even as an actor when you just gave up your judgment and you said, this is really useful. I'm not, can we take you, can it be lighter than this? Essay moments that you have.
Honestly, initially when I started this show for first one and a half year, definitely it was very, very disturbing. I think Juhi can vouch for this because when I used to drop Imam, there's a lot of traffic outside the school and there are, you know, volunteers who keep telling you, let's just move. But I used to keep my eye till the time my son is entering the main gate, then only I'll move my car. People are honking, I know there's traffic, but you know, there was so much of fear that I should have the memory that he has entered the school. Then I'm satisfied, I'm like at peace. So it was very disturbing, and there are times when I discuss with the channel also that, you know, are we doing the correct thing? Are we doing, by making this show, are we really making some kind of an awareness? But then I realized that why not take it in a positive way? Because when I started meeting people in public, like for example, I remember I was at Delhi airport and I met a girl, you know, who was working with some multinational company and, you know, laptop on the shoulder, and she was flying to Bangalore. And she just came to me, she said that, you know, since I've seen that particular episode of yours, the moment I take a taxi from home to go to the airport, I take a picture of the number plate and I, you know, pass it on to my family members, my friends. The moment I land in Bangalore, so the company's taxi which has come to pick me up, I'll take the picture of that particular number plate and I... So I realized that that means there is a positive change, and I realized I should stick to this show. Because, jaise hum kehte hain na ke, chahe, 100 gunegar ban jaye aur ek innocent ko saza nahi milni chahiye, to agar itne lakhon logon mein se agar kuch percentage bhi agar iska ek benefit utha paate hain, to why not? So I think since then it was very positive, and the way I started talking to people, to the camera, to my audience, it made a hell of a lot of difference. And as far as this book you said, obviously this thing when Oswald and me were discussing, I know him for last 6 years, and somehow when he said that let's do something together, so we discussed and we came through this idea, and we shortlisted almost 30 cases, and out of 30 then it came down to 15, and then finally we locked 8. He started writing, and then one day he called me that he spoke to Sudha, and Sudha is excited to know that we are doing something like this, and like within minutes she said that okay, our publication will publish this book now. So I'm happy. The whole process was that we should choose cases which will definitely, as a reader, you should enjoy reading, because obviously aisa bhi nahi hona chahiye ki bahut boring kitab hai aur aapko maza bhi nahi aa raha padhne. So it should be exciting enough to make you involved, but at the same time it should convey, which was our like the sole message from this book, is that crime never pays. You might have 20,000 problems, but crime is not the solution for that.
He said boring now, but these are the most thrilling stories, and each one is written in a very edgy fashion. In my office, when the copies came, everyone took one copy and ran away and started reading it, but everyone also told me, all this is fine, but we don't get it. Because they had seen and read, you know, they were aware of this. We don't care, Oswald. Do you agree? As a society, we don't care. That it can be happening, like John said, to someone else, and we'll read and we'll say, tut tut, very bad. But as a society, we have to evolve to care about each other.
As a society, as John also said, we are a very callous society. Only when it happens to us, we care. When it happens to someone else, we in fact enjoy. We take a vicarious pleasure of someone else's sorrow. And you know, Indians, they have a lot of sanskriti. When it comes to reality, there's no sanskriti. We are, I don't know, we don't have empathy for poor, we don't have empathy for victims of crime. So I think we need to evolve as a society.
John, crime really sells. It's a fact, whether it's on television and film. The gorier the crime, the better the film. We have recent series on certain, you know, where it sells because they say the crime is. Men have always liked the shooting, women have always liked emotional drama. So crime cells. Do you think that in an evolved society, maybe they can deal with crime and sex? But do you think the kind of war they show here, as a person who belongs to the film industry, do you think that it is fair on the society? Do you think it really impacts a lot of people to go out there and do things the way it's been done?
So films are an influencer, so that's a fact. Crime does sell, just to answer your point by point, crime does sell. Do we want to make films on crime? Yes, we want to make films on crime. And you know, I speak as a producer when I'm sitting here. My thought is, you know, there must be something interesting in this book that I could pick up to make into a film. How do people react, or do they get influenced by this? Yes, people do get influenced by this. Like Anup said, there are sometimes people who get influenced by it positively. Yeah, there may be some people who get influenced by the nature of the crime that takes place. Are we making, is today ready to make films like this for an audience, like for a target group, for a teaching to actually sit and watch films like this? Well, we are very bloody man. What we're doing basically right now is especially through digital, we're making content so war that we're going to create an issue for ourselves for censorship. So we are going to become recipients of censorship very soon without realizing it. So I think we're doing it to ourselves. So we as makers are kind of catalyzing the process and making it move faster in that direction. So yes, there are people out here who enjoy programs on Amazon, on Netflix, on Jio, all the digital platforms. But at the same time, you know, there's going to be censorship from parents. There's going to be censorship from seniors. There's finally going to be censorship from government. And when governance comes in, when censorship comes in from there, then things become harder. So it's a complicated process. We deal with it every day in films when you go in for your censors are doing it.
So, you know, you're a producer of Indian Daughter, sweet film, very nice film. But would you, as a producer, do a film which is a fabulous story, but which actually where the hero is violence? You know, eulogizing somebody who's absolutely cruel, let's say someone like Idi Amin or Paul Mondi, for instance. Would you, as a producer, take it up because it's a good story and it will do well because it's got commercial value, or you'll think about it?
So if you're asking me specifically, or would a producer do it? Or me? So I would do films that are very interesting, that are very intriguing. I mean, not because I'm trying to promote my film on the stage, so that's a disclaimer, but I'm doing a film on a subject that has really interested me. I'm sure Sir knows about the Bhatla House incident that happened. It's in the north of India, it's the most contentious subject after Babri Masjid, probably. And the more I read about it, the more it intrigues me in my head. Every day and I get disturbed. So for us, it's very important. So to answer your question, I'm also producing the film. So when you're producing it, I made Madras Cafe. For me, it's very clear that you make a film, you show all perspectives. Show the perspective of probably the Delhi police, the perspective of the victims, the perspective of the witnesses. So when, as an audience, you walk out, you decide to choose who you think is right. And I think that's what a film should do. To answer your question, it should kind of influence you. And the first film that did that for me was an English film called Schindler's List. Because when I walked out, I was like, oh man, this is actually making you think. It's fantastic.
So he doesn't insult the intelligence of the audience, which is so wonderful to know. This book, you respect us, and that's really nice to know that we all can have an opinion. This book doesn't just have cases from the four metros, you know, Bangalore, Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata. But it has cases from all over it. So just to peg and say that, no, it happens only with rich people who live in Palihil or, you know, who live in Juhu, wherever, whatever the rich places are in Mumbai. That's not true. It is happening around us. It is happening in smaller cities. And that's what is the question to you, Anup. Was it deliberate on your and Oswald?